Should you get a job as a data scientist? If data science is in such demand, how come it's so difficult to get a job as a data scientist? And is data science a safe career option given all the developments and automation that's going on within the field? These are just some of the questions that we are going to address inside this video. If you're new to this channel and you're keen to learn the latest tips, tricks, and tools for working more effectively with data, please hit the subscribe button for weekly videos. Now, the two most common answers I see to these questions are, first of all, passion. If you're not passionate about data science, then maybe you shouldn't be getting into data science as a career path. Because if you're not really passionate about the field, then you're not really going to be any good at it. If you're not any good at it, you're not going to be able to get a job in that field, no matter how well it pays and how sexy the job seems at the current time. Now, the second point is experience. Now, this one's a bit of a catch-22, because if you don't have experience in the field, how are you supposed to get into it in the first place? Now, here's the thing. Data science is still a very, very new field, and so there aren't a lot of people who have experience in it because there haven't really been data science jobs before, or even any data science qualifications. Now that we have all these online certifications that are so easy to get, we have millions of people with these data science qualifications, but that don't have any experience in the field. Now, this is a bit of a problem. So people are saying, well, how do you get your foot in the door? Because, you know, you don't necessarily have these PhDs or this massive amount of experience to get started in the industry. Now, the thing is that because the field is still so new, you kind of need more experienced people in there in the first place to kind of front run a lot of the development that's happening. A lot of companies who could benefit from and utilize data science, well, they really don't know how to manage data science projects. They don't know what to expect, they don't know what to do, and so it wouldn't make any sense for them to hire junior data scientists because they wouldn't know what to tell them what to do. Now, here's the key thing I want to add to these two points. A lot of people are kind of complaining that everybody's just jumping into data science because it's the new in thing. And, you know, really, it's just another type of job. But actually, I think it's a little bit more than that as well, because data science is changing the way a lot of things work. Data science is changing the way that we develop software. Data science is changing the way that we look at and think about working with data. So I think it is actually something important that people need to look into. But here's the problem. A lot of people are going off and thinking, well, that means I need to go off and I need to pursue a career as a data scientist. And that, for a lot of people, I think is probably kind of the wrong thing to do. Now, here's the thing. I think instead of looking at data science as a career, I think it's better for most people to be looking at data science more like a new set of tools that give us new capabilities. A little bit like an electric screwdriver. You don't necessarily need to be a builder to appreciate and be able to use something like an electric screwdriver. It's still going to be really handy to be able to do a few bits of DIY and everything around your home without having to be completely dependent on some trade expert. So if you're something like an accountant, maybe you don't want to try and completely rechange your career into a data science from an accountant. Maybe instead you want to be looking at, how is data science relevant to your field of expertise? How could you be using something like machine learning to automatically classify different expense items? How could you maybe use it to detect fraudulent transactions? Now, even much simpler than that, a lot of professionals who work with numbers and data could benefit hugely from some of the tools that data scientists use without even having to go into some of the more complicated things. For example, things like TensorFlow and deep learning are hugely important technologies which have enabled things like self-driving cars, image recognition, and voice recognition, things like Apple Siri. But if you're an accountant, then maybe that's not the first thing that you kind of want to learn on your to-do list. Maybe it's much more relevant to learn how to work with the type of data that you're already working with today. A lot of organizations don't really have this type of data in place to actually work with. Now, that's not to say that the opportunity isn't there to get involved in all of these different types of interesting projects, but right now, a lot of organizations basically have these big chunky information systems, which then go off and feed data warehouses. Those data warehouses are a bit too big and slow and clunky to work with, so people end up extracting that data out of these data warehouses and going off and sticking them in Excel spreadsheets and building all these complicated models off these Excel spreadsheets, which don't really cope well. Once you get past even 10,000 records or so, these spreadsheets already start to slow down and are really not very scalable solutions. Now, if you're actually interested in getting into anything like data science, well, one of the first things you probably want to do is start using a tool like R or Python, which can basically handle millions of records of data really, really easily without any of these issues that you get with Excel. And that's really the first step, because even if you did nothing but that, you would already make a massive improvement to a lot of the processes that you already do. A huge amount of automation can be done just by moving to some of these tools without technically doing any data science-y kind of projects at all. Now, once you have your data inside tools like that, then you have the opportunity to expand upon that and start getting into things like machine learning and seeing how you can take that data and apply machine learning to your specific problems. But the first thing is really getting into the tool which is going to enable you to do that. Now, between R and Python, I really like working with R, as I think it provides a really nice end-to-end solution for working with a lot of the data that comes out of Excel and databases and publishing that to a whole range of different formats, from effectively a notebook. From a notebook, you can effectively publish it to something like a book or blog, a PowerPoint slide, or to something like a dashboard, with a whole lot less work than would be required with something like Python and Flask, which you really also need to have a lot of web development skills and a lot more code to actually be able to implement. By having some of these skills, I think it's a really nice way to start gaining some experience and producing some pretty cool results with the data that you have today. And this is the way to get real life experience, is to not go out and try and go off and get some data science job, but taking the work that you have today and figuring out different ways of doing it better. Now, I think it's great that we have all this online education online that gives us access to learn all about all these different skills and techniques. But a lot of times, a lot of these things aren't necessarily going to be relevant to you and are really going to cause you a whole lot more confusion. Like I mentioned before, getting into something like deep learning, if you're generally working with Excel and databases, is just going to be way overkill. It's going to be like learning how to drive a forklift to try and move your sofa. There's a lot of proof of concepts and everything like that to show that, well, yes, in theory, you could do this. But in practice, a lot of the times, these things aren't actually practical to use and are really a whole lot of work. Not only that, a lot of these fields are still very, very new. For example, with deep learning, one of the key libraries has been TensorFlow. Now, if you've worked with TensorFlow already, you probably realize that it's actually a pretty difficult and hard library to work with. And a lot of that, if you've been keeping up with the news, has been replaced by TensorFlow 2, which has completely reworked the system and pretty much made a lot of the first version of TensorFlow somewhat irrelevant. So I think it's really important to focus in on what your problems are that you actually need to solve and start trying to find practical ways that you can implement solutions for the work that you're doing and not trying to dive into the most complex algorithms there are available just so you can put something fancy on your CV. So, as mentioned, I think one of the best ways of getting started is basically picking up and learning something like R, because you're going to be able to take that and use that and apply that today for basically the things that you use Excel and databases for, without necessarily having to go off and learn data science, machine learning, statistics, or any of that kind of stuff. Now, are all those kind of things important and useful? Yeah, sure, absolutely, they are going to be. But again, these are skills that you need to build up over time. There are lots of incremental things, and you're still gonna get a ton of benefits just getting this foundation in first. I think a lot of times, courses can just end up using things like R to show you how to build these more complicated solutions without first just showing you how to use it to solve your everyday type of problems. So that's one of the things that I really felt was missing and really wanted to help share with more people, as I think it's a much more practical step for people to get into. So I teach R courses that first focus on all the typical things that you would do with Excel and databases and shows how it can do it faster and better. I also show you how R is one of the best solutions for taking data and turning it into dashboards in interactive web applications. So if you're interested in checking out any of my courses, I'm going to leave a link below. In the meantime, if you found this video helpful, please leave a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.